What we have generally accepted is that when we see new treatments, it comes at a cost. And what this study has shown that you have a new treatment that works better than our standard treatment, but with less side effects. So dramatic improvements in survival, a dramatic improvement in progression-free survival, but less side effects, no side effects that we tend to see with hair loss, no side effects that we tend to see with infection with regular chemotherapy. So I think this is a combination that of targeted drug and chemotherapy packaged into one drug that allows for patients to have a better outcome with less toxicity. We conducted a large phase 3 randomized trial with 213 centers in 26 countries called the EMILIA study, where the patients were randomized to receive TDM1 versus capecitabine and lapatinib in the head-to-head comparison. Capecitabine and lapatinib is our standard treatment for some of our patients who progressed on Herceptin with advanced metastatic breast cancer. Compared to TDM1, which is given through an IV, it's given 90 minutes the first treatment and 30 minutes thereafter every 3 weeks. And the results were initially presented at a large international conference in June, which showed that TDM1 was superior to patients receiving capecitabine and lapatinib, improved the time the disease remained under control. The overall survival, that is, are the patients living longer, was suggested to be improved as well, but was not statistically significant. We recently published this data in the New England Journal of Medicine, and what the data now shows with the second interim analysis is that the patients who received TDM1 not only had cancer that remained under control, but also lived longer than patients who got capecitabine and lapatinib. And what TDM1 is, it's a combination of trastuzumab, which is Herceptin, a monoclonal antibody, and DM1, which is a cytotoxic chemotherapy, and they're linked together through a stable linker. What happens is that this compound, as a single agent, gets to the cancer cell, and there's precision delivery of chemotherapy right to the cancer cell using Herceptin as a delivery vehicle. So you can give chemotherapy, but now in very small doses, because it's linked to this vehicle. This approach of combining an antibody and using that to deliver the chemotherapy right to the cancer cell is the first in solid tumors, the first in breast cancer, but this approach is now going to be studied in many other cancers. If you can try and use antibody to deliver the chemotherapy right to the cancer cell, suddenly opens up the doors for many other cancers where there's identifiable antibodies such as this. So I think this really opens up the door for some exciting research, allowing patients to have better treatments, better results, with less side effects related to chemotherapy.